I don't know where I'm going to. I don't know when I'm going to stop, but it's a journey. I do it for life, and that's my gift for life and my thanks. Life is short, don't make it shorter. Life is nice, make it and beauty, make it be more beautiful. Life is this, sunshine and rain. Masterpiece is not an everyday thing. A wonder happens once a thousand years, not every day. And so the same with work. It's not so much a money-make business, it's more to teach people and to keep life and to give back to life. Yesterday scraps, today masterpiece. Yesterday people had thrown it away, today they buy their own scraps back from me. And that gives me mine.
Run, run, crow, yeah, Santa. Run, run, crow, yeah, 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 oh, my bossy, oh, my man, I'm from. Run, run, crow, run away. Run, run, crow, yeah, Santa. Oh, my bossy, oh, my man, I'm from. Run, run, crow, run away. Run, run, crow, yeah, 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 bye-bye.
This life is hired unto me to decorate this earth with glee. Make something out of nothing and show the world what you're after.
This hands of mine, I please with you, I kiss you. Even in my sleep, I laugh with my hands. I say, you must help me make my life hands.
I'm standing here on the top of this magnificent mountain, the mountain the Zulus call eccentric, 4,300 feet above sea level, and it's indeed on the slopes below me that the British were to suffer their greatest military defeat in the entire colonial history, where 1,800 men on the British side were overwhelmed here by 25,000 Zulu warriors. There was a scene in this battle where there's no doubt that things were beginning to turn for the Zulus. They were about to withdraw, and their withdrawal from this field would have precipitated a mass exodus of Zulu warriors. And they were rallied by a remarkable, remarkable Zulu commander called Mkosana Kamvundlana of the Biela clan. A man who was 75 here at this battle, and he'd run here 80 miles from Ulundi to be at the head of his column, the mighty Mkujo regiment. And he stood up like a colossus behind his men with his old gray beard, and he bellowed at them, Yenina Lapia, Ningabale. You men, don't run, don't run! With that, this beloved old Zulu commander was struck right in the middle of his face by a 480 grain rifle slug and had the entire back of his skull blown off. But the rallying cry had been made. The Zulus got up like a great wave of the ocean when they fell on the thin red firing line. And it's here that the tide of this battle was turned. He has become, I'm proud to tell you, an integral part of Zulu folklore. And his rallying cry is still a great rallying cry for this fine Zulu nation amongst whom it's a privilege to live and work. Thank you.
Problem in your life, you could go and see a Sangoma and they would let you know through spirits or ancestors would speak through them and then give you advice as to how you can change them. Most of the problems that you go to a Sangoma for, a doctor can't fix them. Five trainees there who she supports and does everything for while they're training. She'll train them how to interpret what's being said through them. Almost see exactly when the spirit leaves her. They don't really seem to show very much emotion at all at the end. It's almost as though once they've come out of it, they don't know what they've just done or what they've said.